Hello students, welcome back again to our zoology lecture. And today we are going to start our first phylum, that is phylum Porifera. We have discussed all the basis of classification, all the characters on the basis of which we are going to classify animals. Porifera, the name Porifera was given by Dr. Robert Grant. He coined the term Porifera, and the name was given as these animals are having pores in their body. So Porifera are simply known as pori mane pore, bearing, fera mane bearing animals. And majority two type of pores are found. There is one type of pore which is meant for entry of water, and those pores are known for ostium. And other type of pore which is meant for the exit of water, we call that pore as osculum. So ostria, the single word, or ostium for many pores, these are meant for entry of water, and osculum are meant for exit of water. So the very first point, why the name Porifera? Because these animals have porous body. There are two type of pores. Ostria are generally numerous in number. Osculum are generally single in number. But in certain animal like bath sponge, osculum could be numerous as well. Earlier on, when classification was done, Porifera being sessile were considered as plants. And if you have been ever heard this term, or if you have been ever asked about zoophyta, because these are animals which exhibit a plant-like character, being sessile, they are also commonly known as zoophytons. But later on, the definition was changed. Whittaker came and classified them as Porifera. Remember the name of John Ellis as well. Name of scientists are not that much important actually. They are not generally asked. I'm just generally telling you that Mr. John Ellis, he first recognized the animal-like character of Poriferans, and later on Mr. Robert Grant called those animals as Porifera. Animals are broadly classified into two major divisions. One division is parazoa and second division is eumetazoa. Only Poriferans are parazoans. Parazoans are generally those animals which are having a cellular level of organization. And all the animals from cnidarian to chordate, they would be metazoan. So other name for Porifera is parazoa, and they are commonly known as sponge. And when we talk about bath sponge, we are talking about a dead skeleton of Porifera. Okay, in phylum Porifera, first we will be learning the general features. Then what are the characteristic features which are found only in Poriferans. Then classification of Porifera. So this phylum would be studied in three levels. Classification part is not included in our NCERT, but for competition purpose and but for solving our competitive questions, we have to learn about classification as well. So starting from general features of phylum Porifera, in our basis of classification, we have learned about certain features of Porifera. For example, when I was telling you about the first basis of classification was, first I told you about habitat. I told you that there are certain marine others which are fresh water. Then I told you about habit. I told you about level of organization, body plan and all the things. And in certain places, phylum Porifera has been used as an example. So starting with general features of Porifera, the general characters, general features. First general feature is their habitat. Poriferans are exclusively found in water. They are aquatic in nature, and majority of them are marine in nature. Majority are marine, only a few porifera are found in freshwater. So classical example of freshwater porifera is spongilla. Spongilla is also known as freshwater porifera. That question has been asked multiple times, and when you are going to solve objectives, you will be having that question. Most of the porifera are marine in nature. They are found in seawater. Porifera does not like cold water. They are generally found in warmer water, right? The only exception here, which is found in fresh water, which you have to remember right now, is spongilla. Coming on their habit, so when we are going to learn about common names, spongilla common name is freshwater sponge. So freshwater sponge is spongilla. The second character about their habit. By habit, porifera are the animal which do not move. All the time they have been attached to a solid surface, and that solid surface is known as substratum. So by their habit, they are sessile in nature. Porifera can be found in colonies, or they can be found singly. So those animals which are found in colonies, we call that colonial animal. Or those animals which love to live singly, we call that solitary animal. On the habit, we have discussed like those things. So being sessile, they could be solitary or they could be colonial. Next, few more basis of classification you are going to tell me. Yes, please. What kind of level of organization, level of body organization is found in porifera? Porifera is the only animal in kingdom Animalia which are having cellular grade level of body organization. So their body are having cellular grade level of organization, or let's call that cellular level of organization. I am mentioning cellular grade here. About cellular grade, I have mentioned that earlier on as well, that these cells, all the cells are assigned different function, and they show primitive type of division of labor, and these cells also exhibit a good power of regeneration, which we are going to discuss later on. Is that clear? Okay. Some more features. Yes. What about body symmetry? Most of the porifera are asymmetrical in nature. Most of porifera, as they are very primitive animal, there is no uniform distribution of body tissue. They do not have tissues actually. They only have cells, and cells are not uniformly distributed. So mostly they are asymmetrical, with the exception of few. And I have told you asymmetrical. I have told you two exceptions here. One exception is Cycan is having radial symmetry and Leucosolenia is having radial symmetry. So radial symmetry is found in two members. One is Cycan here and second is Leucosolenia here. Remember what was radial symmetry when plane of axis cut the body from top to bottom into two or more equal halves? We called that radial symmetry. Alright, now coming on other features. You tell me now, what about their phylum? Do they have phylum? Answer is no. So they do not even have mesoderm. And when body is not lined by mesoderm, how can phylum be formed? Body wall. See, there are certain authors which classify them as diploblastic. I am telling you this if you are going through any reference book, whatever the name is, I am not going to reveal the name. Most of the reference book have mentioned them diploblastic, and that is not true in nature, because they do not even have tissues. How germinal layer could be formed? So they have two cellular membrane. One would be pinacoderm, other would be coenoderm. They are not truly diploblastic. Please remember that. The first truly diploblastic animal which were evolved was cnidarian. But as certain authors have mentioned that thing, I told you that thing. So body wall, there is an outer body wall and there is an inner body wall, and these body wall do not contain tissues, they only contain cell. The outer body wall is known as pinacoderm. Which other people hypothetically consider as ectoderm, but you don't have to learn that thing. And inner body wall is known as coenoderm, which other people hypothetically consider as endoderm, but they are not true endoderm or ectoderm. I will be telling you, okay, what is a tissue? We have learned that a group of cells performing similar function along with certain intercellular material is called a tissue. There is another condition which should be filled. There is a very important membrane over which tissue lies, and this membrane is known as basement membrane. And I will be telling you, there is no basement membrane over pinacoderm and coenoderm, so they are not regarded as tissue. And secondly, we have been learning they are only having cellular level of organization. How could they be having tissue? So now we are going to learn about body wall here. Between pinacoderm and coenoderm, there is a known cellular space. A layer is there which is not consist of cells. A known cellular space is there which we call mesohyal layer. See, between ectoderm and endoderm, we have learned a gelatinous material layer which we call mesoglia. And there is mesohyal layer. And mesohyal is derived from pinacoderm and coenoderm cell. The cell of pinacoderm and coenoderm would be resting in mesohyal space. There is no cells in the mesohyal itself. One more important thing to remember, that sometimes question has been asked, mesohyal layer is derived from. Don't go on mesoderm, please. They do not have mesoderm. Despite of the fact the name is meso, sometimes you get confused. The question is like, mesohyal layer is derived from ectoderm, mesoderm or endoderm. Oh yes, we know the answer. Let's go for mesoderm. Wrong answer. Okay, yes, body wall. So we are going to learn body wall in detail now. As I told you, outer layer is pinacoderm and inner layer is coenoderm. Pinacoderm consists of two type of cells. You can add it here. I am just making this side. Pinacoderm would be consisting of certain flattened cell, and these flattened cells are known as pinacocyte. And pinacoderm also consists of certain oval shaped cell, and these oval shaped cells are vacuolated cells. They are having an opening in them. Remember that a tube like opening is present in these oval shaped cell, and let's call that podocyte. Easy way to remember, these cells are porous in nature. Actually ostia would be present there. So outer layer pinacoderm is made by flattened pinacocyte and oval shaped porocyte. And inner layer, which is coenoderm, it is made by special cells which are the characteristic cell of phylum Porifera, and the name is coelocyte, and due to their shape they are known as collar cells. So coelocytes or collar cells are characteristic cells present in Porifera, and they are present in the inner layer. So just make a diagram here, and I will be telling you how these pinacoderm and how these coenoderm are aligned, and how the shape, how the general shape of a sponge look like. So what is the basic shape of a Porifera animal? Is that clear? Alright. So let us make a diagram here. This here, the lower part, let's say substratum, and as I told you, these animals are sessile. They do not move all the time. They have been attached to a solid surface, and that solid surface is substratum. We will be making animal like this. Let's say this is one wall of animal body, and that is other wall of animal body. And as I am telling you, these walls would be double layered. They would be two different layer of cells which are present on both sides. Okay, let me make it. Let's say there are certain cells which are like this. Yes, please, what should be the name of these cells which are flattened? Let's call them pinacocyte. And there are certain cells which are like this. with a pore here. What should be the name? Porocyte. Then flattened pinacocyte, oval shaped porocyte with a tube like this, again flattened pinacocyte, oval shaped porocyte. The thing would go like this all the length of body, and again there should be pinacocyte here. Does it make a sense? Yes. So this is what I draw here, pinacoderm, and this is one cell here. I am making one nucleus. See why I am telling you this. So, there was a question that this opening, to be very specific, is meant for entry of water. What should be the name? Ostium. These are ostium here, and this single opening which is meant for exit of water, let's say this is osculum. Once upon an exam there was a question that ostium is lined by how many cells, and by diagram we used to learn that there are two cells which have been lining it. Answer is no. There is a cell here, and in this cell this is single nucleus. So half part of cell is this side, half part of cell is this side. Or you can say only single cell line, or only single cell covered the opening which we call ostium. So outer part is clear here. Okay. On the inner side, let me make conoderm here. They are special cell which are flagellated. Okay. I will love to tell you what is the study of porifera known as. We call it parazoology. And it is believed that poriferas are evolved from protozoa. Poriferas are evolved from protozoa. Okay, there are certain cells which are having flagella here. We'll be making the detailed structure of this cell. Just I am making it for the anatomical purpose. And let's say this layer of cell in the green color is the inner layer of cell. And what should be the name? Yes, please. We call that choanoderm. Is that clear? So this is pinacoderm here, this is choanoderm here, and that space in between pinacoderm and choanoderm, what should be the name? That should be known as mesohyl layer or mesohyl space. That's easy to remember. These are pinacocyte, this is porocyte, and within porocyte is an opening which we call ostium. Similarly, this side, I am just making a very rough diagram here. There would be again flat cells along with certain oval shaped cells. These oval shaped cells are porocytes, and those flat cells are pinacocyte. And on the inner membrane, there should be choanocytes or polar cell here. Yes. Okay. This is the most primitive structure, simplest structure of a sponge, which I am going to draw here. There is a cavity which is present, and that cavity, for cavity, what would you use? Seal. And that is the cavity of sponges. Let's call that spongocoel. And other name of that cavity, it is not stomach. Digestion would never ever take place here. It is also known as paragastric cavity. Why we call that? We will be learning in digestion topic of sponges. So normally what is happening here? Water comes substratum. Water comes from these opening. It goes into the cavity which is spongocoel. Utilize whatever important things need to be taken, it would be taken. Whatever things has been expelled out, it would be expelled out, and later on all the things would be thrown out at osculum here. Is that clear? Okay. And I have not drawn any basement membrane here. Remember, pinacoderm and choanoderm are without basement membrane. What is present in mesohyl space here? In mesohyl space there are certain cells which show pseudocodial movement or which is not having very definite shape. एक ऐसा ऑर्गेनिज्म जिसका टेढ़ा मेढ़ा शेप होता है आप उसको क्या कहते हैं. ओके द थिंग विच क्लिक इन योर माइंड इज अमीबा एंड दो सेल्स लुक लाइक अमीबा द नेम शुड गो अमीबोसाइट. विद इन दैट स्पेस देयर सर्टेन सेल ड्राइव फ्रॉम क्वायरोडर्म एंड पिनाकोडर्म एंड दो सेल्स आर नोन एज अमीबोसाइट्स. सो अमीबोसाइट्स आर द डिफरेंट टाइप ऑफ सेल्स. व्हाई आई एम यूजिंग द वर्ड डिफरेंट टाइप because these cells would be having cellular level of division or division of labor and each cell would be performing different function. So amoebocytes are the cell which is present here and there and depending upon the function we are given them a name. For example, I'm going to tell you about types of amoebocytes now. So, amoebocytes are the cell derived from pinacoderm and coenoderm and depending upon their function amoebocytes are classified as the very first most important. See, this is something which we call differentiation, a differentiated cell. For example, right now I am not assigned any function. So I will say I am not differentiated. And when a cell is assigned to perform a particular function, exactly that cell is known as differentiated cell. A cell which can be differentiated any type of cell. For example, right now I am idle, I am sitting free. अभी मैं कुछ भी नहीं कर रहा हूं. If you ask me to do a task, what can I do? I can teach. You got my point? If you are asking me to play cricket on international level, can I be able of it? Answer is no, because I am not specialized to do that thing. So my functions are very limited. I am not having complete potency. In case if there is a cell and when needed, that cell can differentiate into any type of cell. At the time of need, a cell, an undifferentiated cell, which can differentiate into any type of cell, we call that cell as totipotent cell. So there are certain cells which are not differentiated and they are totipotent. They can give rise to any type of cell. Name of that cell is erythrocyte. So erythrocyte are undifferentiated totipotent cells. You got my point? They are having the property of like stem cells. A lot of time this question has been asked, which cells of sponges are totipotent? Answer is erythrocyte. Then they have been named according to their function. Other cell, let's talk about those cells which used to transport food to other cell. When we talk, this is, there is a word in biology which we call trough, and trough means nourishment. So those cells which have been transporting, which have been providing nourishment to other cell, those cells are known as trophocyte. Trophocyte. Okay, one more important thing. Trophocytes do not undergo digestion, remember this. Trophocytes only transport the digested food. This is what we call nourishment. ऐसा तो नहीं है ना भाई घर पे सब्जी नहीं बनी हो तुम लोगों को सर्व करना शुरू कर दो. नहीं, first that vegetable need to be cooked properly and after that you can serve it. So trophocytes are the one which provide nourishment to other cell. Okay, then there are certain cells which used to store food. क्या पता कल खाना मिले या ना मिले. Okay, one thing here, see, when we talk about direction of water, water has been coming like this and then it has been moving like this. Easy to remember? Can you predict the flow of water? If this is the substratum, they have been living on the surface of water or depth of water? I'll say it would be depth of water. And animals are living like this. If water is moving by very high speed, what would happen? This animal would detach from here. So water flow through this canal system. We'll be learning the characteristic feature along with color cell is canal system as well. Water through canal system run very very slow. It is about 0.01 mm per second. The speed of water is only about 0.01 mm per second. Okay. So with this water, along with certain, this water would be having a lot of minerals, certain microorganisms would be going there, certain small plant material would be going there, and these cells would be engulfing. Whatever the cells are present here, they would be engulfing things here. And I will be telling you digestion occurs inside these cells. That type of digestion would be referred as to intracellular digestion. Anyways, let it be. Let us talk about amebocyte first. Other third type of cell which used to store food, let's call them thesocyte. Clear? They store food. Sponges do not have an exoskeleton, but they have a well-defined endoskeleton. And endoskeleton is either made up of spongin fibers, either there are a lot of fibers which are present there, or there are certain hard structures which are present like this. And let's call that hard structure as spicule. So endoskeleton is well defined and it is made up of spongin fiber and spicule. Those cells which make spongin fibers, those cells are known as spongioblast. They used to make spongin fibers. And the other cells which make spicule, we call that scleroblast. Scleroblast make spicules. Spicules are rod-like structure which provide support to the internal body. They do not have exoskeleton, and endoskeleton is made by spicule. This spicule could be made up of calcium or it could be made up of silicon. Depending upon either calcium spicule is there, if calcium spicule is there, then the name of this cell is calcoblast. And if silicon spicule is there, then the name of this cell is siliceoblast. Done up to here. Okay. Then which is the most abundant protein in animals? Answer is collagen. And those cells which actually synthesize collagen fiber are referred as to collagenocyte. So next type of cell here. Next type of cell is collagenocyte. Collagenocytes, they make, what they synthesize? They synthesize collagen fiber. Synthesize collagen fiber. Remember, collagen protein is the most abundant protein in animals. Moreover, there are certain cells which keep on secreting some sticky material, and such cells is known as gland cell. Other type of cell which is secreting sticky material, let's call them gland cells. They secrete sticky material. Okay. Gonads are not developed in sponges. For the development of gonad, at least tissue level of organization is needed. In cellular level of organization, there is no development of gonad. Only germ cells are there. See, sponges being very primitive can reproduce by both means. They can reproduce sexually and they can also reproduce asexually. In reproduction, we will be learning that in reproduction of sponges. For sexual reproduction, whenever the breeding session comes, there are certain cells, certain amoebas, certain erythrocyte which specialize to make gamete, and those cells are known as germ cells. So next here is germ cells. And these germ cells, they make gametes. Okay. There are other cells which are present here. One is phagocyte. And as the function, as the name tells, phagocytosis ka matlab hota hai to engulf foreign particle. तो जितना भी उनका ब्रेकडाउन प्रोडक्ट है, जितना भी वेस्ट प्रोडक्ट है, वो इंगल्फ कर लेती है फैगोसाइटोटिक सेल. With that, फैगोसाइटोटिक सेल आल्सो गेट नरिशमेंट और आल्सो एब्जॉर्ब फूड फ्रॉम कॉलर सेल. सो फैगोसाइटोटिक सेल वुड बी परफॉर्मिंग टू फंक्शन, इट एब्जॉर्ब और इंगल्फ फूड फ्रॉम कॉलर सेल और लेट्स से क्वाइनोसाइट, प्लस they also engulf dead and waste material in the body. Later it has been thrown outside in the spongocele and it goes away. One more very important cell I will love to mention here. There are certain cells which are having contractile ability, and these cells are majorly present on the neck of osculum. Because they are having contractile ability, we call it myo. Myo stands for muscle, and we call it myocyte. And myocyte, they control closing and opening of osculum. So right now what I am telling you about their body wall, outside pinacoderm, inside coenoderm, in between is mesohyal space, and that mesohyal space consists of different cells which are not having defined shape, we call it amoebocyte. And these amoebocytes are named according to their function. Within here are certain fibers which we call spongin fibers, and certain rod-like elements are also present. These rod-like elements could be like this, they could be like this, or they could be like this. This is about cells present in mesohyal space. Is that clear? Next, we are going to learn about the structure of coenocyte now. We have discussed about the functions of amoebocyte, and both amoebocytes are derived from coenoderm as well as pinacoderm. Why coenocyte is fantastic cell? Why coenocyte is known as collar cell? What is the function of that flagella? Okay, one more thing. The germ cells, they make gamete, and the sperms in their case are with tail, and ovum is immotile, right? That question is also asked. Sometimes we used to think that these primitive animal, how can they have a tail in their sperm? But they have tail in their sperm. Next, I'm going to tell you about structure of coenocyte, right? We are going to learn about the structure of coenocyte, that why coenocyte are known as characteristic cell, and what are the different functions of coenocyte, right? Just give me 2 minutes, we will be covering coenocyte, then binding up this lecture. I guess it would be taking a lot of time to note things. काफी मुश्किल होता होगा वीडियो को बार बार पॉज करके नोट्स बनाना. कई बार तो विजिबिलिटी चली जाती है ड्यू टू इंटरनेट कनेक्शन. बट ड्यूरिंग लॉकडाउन वी हैव टू मैनेज ऑल दीज थिंग्स. ओके, द लास्ट पार्ट, स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ क्वाइनोसाइट, द करेक्टरिस्टिक सेल ऑफ, लेट्स कॉल इट कॉलर सेल. ओके सर, आपने बाकी सेल के स्ट्रक्चर तो पढ़ा ही नहीं, क्वाइनोसाइट का क्यों? दीज आर द करेक्टरिस्टिक सेल, एंड वी डोंट नीड टू लर्न द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ ऑल सेल्स हियर. द ऑल द स्पेशलाइजेशन हैज बीन टोल्ड. क्वाइनोसाइट, they are, let's say this is the major cellular part, that is nucleus here, there is a basal body, from here rhizoblast rises, you don't have to remember this. Here this area develops a lot of protoplasmic extensions like this, and they are like microvilli here. And due to that protoplasmic extensions, the shape become like that of collar. It is like I am standing up my collar, right? Okay. And secondly, oops, my collar. That process arises and become flagella. So right now, what you have to remember, that this is a flagellated cell. Flagellated cell. Okay. There are certain animal which we call coenoflagellates. They are not animal, they are actually protozoans, and coenoflagellates are the most recent ancestor of protozoan, of porifera, or closest ancestor of poriferan is coenoflagellate. These are the protozoans which you will be learning later on. Flagellates. अच्छा, एक ऑर्गेनिज्म होता है जिसके अंदर दो अलग अलग फाइलम के कैरेक्टर्स होते हैं, और उस ऑर्गेनिज्म को बोलते हैं कनेक्टिंग लिंक, अगर वो जिंदा है, और अगर वो जिंदा नहीं है तो उसको बोलेंगे मिसिंग लिंक. तो पॉलीफेरा प्रोटोजोआ का जब कनेक्टिंग लिंक डिस्कस करते हैं तो नाम आता है प्रोटेरो स्पॉन्जिया or Proterozoospongia. Proterospongia or Proterozoospongia, that is the connecting link between protozoa and porifera. कहने को तो ये protozoan है, पर इसके अंदर porifera जैसे character आ जाते हैं. Anyway, coming back to this cell, microvilli is there and whatever, see, if I come back on this part and I am zooming this one, it would be microvilli here and this is the flagella. Whatever water is engulfed, it would be filtered first and then water would be going inside. So these cells are also, or these animals are also known as filter feeder. And why the name filter feeder? Because they are filtering all the water coming inside, and that all specialization is due to the development of microvilli. So jo bhi pani andar aayega, by using their flagella, उस पानी में जितनी भी जरूरत वाली चीजें हैं उनको ये कॉलर सेल इंगल्फ कर लेते हैं, और डाइजेशन इस कैविटी में नहीं होता है, ये याद रखेंगे. अगर डाइजेशन इस कैविटी में हो जाता तो इस कैविटी के लिए वर्ड यूज करते हैं हम स्टमक. जो भी फूड होगा वो डाइजेस्ट होगा इनसाइड दीज कॉलर सेल, ऐसे डाइजेशन को बोलते हैं इंट्रासेलुलर डाइजेशन. लेट्स से दिस इज अ न्यूक्लियस हियर, this is cytoplasm here, you don't need to mention all these things. This is parabasal body or parabasal granules, and that's your flagella. Okay, functions, जैसे हम सारे cell की function पढ़ रहे हैं, इसके भी function पढ़ लेते हैं. First, color cells are involved in intracellular digestion. तो जो भी digestion होगा बच्चे वो कहां पर होगा, it would be occurring in color cell. सेकेंड, आप याद रखेंगे जो फ्लैजिला है इट कीप ऑन मूविंग लाइक दिस. आप अगर फॉर एग्जांपल यू हैव बीन स्ट्रक इन अ रिवर और यू हैव बीन स्ट्रक इन अ लेक, द वाटर इज नॉट मूविंग बट यू वांट टू मूव और यू वांट टू कीप द वाटर मूविंग, तो व्हाट यू हैव बीन डूइंग, यू हैव बीन यूजिंग, यू हैव बीन वेविंग योर हैंड्स. सो इफ यू हैव बीन आस्क्ड दैट विच ऑफ द सेल मेंटेन द करंट ऑफ वाटर, भाई वाटर आगे मूव करेगा तभी तो एंटर करेगा, प्रेशर जब चेंज होगा. तो जो करंट ऑफ वाटर है इट इज आल्सो कंट्रोल्ड, करंट ऑफ वाटर फ्लो इट इज आल्सो कंट्रोल्ड बाय कॉलर सेल. तो फॉर द टाइम बीइंग आप दो चीज याद रख लेंगे, कॉलर सेल एक इंट्रासेलुलर डाइजेशन कर रहा है और दूसरा वो मेंटेन कर रहा है करंट ऑफ वाटर फ्लो. So this is about the body wall of porifera, right? Next, I am going to tell you about the characteristic feature जो किसी animal के पास नहीं होता, सिर्फ porifera phylum में मिलेगा. That is water canal system. So other general characters along with water canal system that we will be discussing in next lecture. This is all for today. I hope कि आपको ये सब चीजें समझ आई होंगी. And if you are having your doubts, again you can text me or you can call me. Thank you. Stay safe at your homes. Best wishes. Class is dismissed.